I am the new man that came down from God. In check, when I was replacing a very Jesus Christ, a prison saint. He made me so many times. Then when they called me, I was coming to two projects. They were so disappointed. And some people didn't know Mama, who speak a lot of language, started, oh, wow. And the bishop took out our priest, and this is what he's bringing to us. Apache. The woman told me that check it. She is also another mommy, you have to experience it. The mama, Maria Dada. Maria Dada, yes, the most fair. Now, dear friends in God, Jesus is calling us to have a relationship with him. Many of you have come for you and experience it. In many environments, ways, that is religion, that is spirituality. Your faith in God translates to the way we relate with one another. Some people meet you and they say, I want to know your parents. I met one woman at the university here also. He said, Father, let me ask you, are your parents, the same of your parents, the teacher, say yes. Say yes, when I see your parents, you have been disciplined. My papa was here. The good guy can be, they can't be a lot of people, so you can never come from the community over here. But when you see the teacher's son, go and touch the back, when you want to be out of class, it's because you cannot afford to make it pay. You begin paying your part of the COVID protocol by then. And if you discipline, you don't realize by saving. But this day in our country and in our world, then you become a difficult person. Everywhere you go, what is so difficult? Because there are things you can't accept. Because you move from a certain discipline, which we are lost now. Beloved, having a relationship means committing. And Jesus wants us to do just that. Not just to say, I relate to Christ, but I also have a commitment. And this commitment is so broad. Many of us, we like good relationships. And good relationship means, I have a friend who always supports me no matter what. That is no relationship, that's no friendship. And so those who tell us the truth, we don't like them. But that was not this woman. She said, as it is. Money, since you have a success in your company, that's and you and mother, are you the only people working together? Can't other people also work with you? You are always with mother. He says, mother don't say this. Father, why are you coming from my sister? If you bring offer to you, tell him, hey, where did you get it from? Parents do not ask this. Do not ask this. But you have a parent who do this. I remember some time ago, we were checking, she and my aunt, they were checking my sister's sense. They are now in sixth form. And mommy was insisting they have to check the things they are taking to school. And then one of them, how many she had made, she had me, he said, this is human rights abuse. Sixth form, I want to check my things. Who has the boss? Then my aunt told my mother, we can't go to that many friends. If the men were the last one, we can't control the group. Our women are here. They check you, you go to your camp, and they check whatever you have. We the boys are together, they give you provisions, and then in the night you smell milk. Somebody's chewing his milk, then he wants to chew yours. And I didn't know that the senior ones have a way of doing it. In the last day when they are going, they put sand in the middle thing. Because daddy and mommy come and check whether they are sand there. I didn't know, I could sew. So when she lifted up and said, hey, Silo! It's coming from her. It's too heavy. But the woman is too. We are putting our men. I think you can imagine. Your parents going to your boss to be sure that you are taking to school. So today, as you think about her, you think about the relationship she shared with her. And she did all this because she had a very deep relationship with God. Very deep. I told you those of you came for the funeral, we have two bishops, well, we have many bishops coming. And one bishop said, he's going to tell the whole congregation because people think he came because of me. So no, they have a relationship with money. They came there on their own. So they remember how money took care of them as a merit. Bishop Umani was as a sawa with his first post. And he has some challenges there. And that was the time when he had left mainstream work and was in contact with there on the time. And Bishop, come on, you tell you, in your mother, I found my mother. And so now as a bishop, when he heard from me, he said, I shouldn't invite you. You can't know what to invite you. It's his mother. Can they say this about that? What is the relationship you have with one another? The second is student for me, many of us bear all kinds of anger against one another, grudges. Where are we taking this? At the end of the day, what do they say about you? What will be your legacy? What are you leaving behind? I would like people to say you are crazy, but this crazy man who always puts us in check. I will not compromise what is bad, that something you regret knowing me. We must cherish dissent. Dissent is to correct us. So family of the Lord gathered this morning into the afternoon. You have come here to celebrate with me 1 year of our mother. Let the next celebration you have should be a memory of her life. Part of her life that we found. Let us hold on to it and do say that when people are not there and are not there, people should remember us. For we have fallen in love with Christ, and Christ has so much influence our life. A number of people are not too well. I'm surprised that people have come. They are sick, they have told you. I said, they will come. Because you are telling them, Father will come. We will come. Yes, you have come. Let us depart with this knowledge that at the end of the day, it is not the number of quotations you know in the Bible. It's not the number of masses you have attended, but our life with Christ. How has it influenced you? How has it influenced me? So that when people see us, they will be drawn to Christ. Then we have become Christ-like. So the communion we take each day is supposed to be just as far. Transform us to become Christ-like. Yes, Christ has challenges. His own disciples betrayed him. But his focus was on what the Lord has sent him to come and do. His relationship with the Father could not be destroyed. That's what your friends will do. Are you a Christian? Are you in love with Christ? Demonstrate it. Show it to the person closest. May the Lord grant eternal rest to Helen. And when she has already peace to the Lord, we should pray for Lawrence, the family to left behind, and especially we the siblings, that her memory should be continued in our lives. It should not be in books, in videotapes. Her memory should continue in our lives. And when people see her, they should be able to say, that is a child of Helen. That is a Christian because we are living in Christ. Amen.
And last continuation of prayer.
Thank you. and to all who are listening to you at the passing of this life.
Jesus, who invites us to a relationship and a commitment,
Where is your sister brother?
Of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.